Welcome back, y'all. This tutorial will help you get the most out of Recover Faces in Photo AI. Let's start by selecting an image we want to work with. This is a scanned slide from the early 60s. You can see there isn't a lot of sharpness here to begin with. The subject's faces are very blurry, but it's such a nice photo, it'd be great if we can recover it. The first thing we're going to do is add a sharpening enhancement to try and bring back some of the details. In this case, Autopilot has automatically selected the subject for us, but we'll go ahead and switch the model to Lens Blur V2. We can dial in the strength by looking at the man's jacket. Sharpening helped a lot, but created some strange artifacts on the faces. We can fix it using Recover Faces, one of Photo AI's most powerful models, that can restore faces while still maintaining a realistic and recognizable appearance. You can add Recover Faces from either the Enhancements menu or from Autopilot. When faces are detected in an image, Autopilot will usually show it as the first recommendation. We'll go ahead and choose Recover Faces from Autopilot. You can see it selected all three faces in this image. If for some reason you didn't want to restore all the faces, you can simply click on one to deselect it. This can be really helpful if there are faces that should stay out of focus, like if they are in the background or foreground of the image. We recommend that you always try the latest version of Recover Faces. We're always working to make the model better at things like glasses, facial hair, and faces that aren't looking directly at the camera. Below the version, you can adjust the model between realistic and creative modes. The realistic mode maintains the highest fidelity to the original image. The creative mode can make people look less recognizable to folks who know them, but has more room to improve faces that are small or turned away from camera. These folks are looking straight at camera, so we'll stick with the realistic mode. The next thing we can adjust is strength. Strength controls how much blending is being done back to the original image. For most cases, we think 80% is just about perfect. If we close the selection, you can see it's done a really good job of bringing back this image. It's almost like it's new. The people are really recognizable. Their facial features are very natural. The subjects just pop without looking out of place. And it works especially well in this image where there is a naturally shallow depth of field. We added nice sharpening on the subject and the faces, but kept all the background original. And that's it. Check out the rest of our Photo AI tutorial series on YouTube.